Hi, in this video we are going to talk about B-trees and access times in the main, so let's get started. In the previous video we have been talking about external memories and why is it good to use B-trees in the main, and I would like to tell a few more words about access times. So accessing items on the external memory is very, very slow, as we have discussed in the previous video. For example, accessing items on the hard disk is approximately 19 milliseconds in average. As far as the main memory, so the random access memory access time is concerned, it is 0.0001 millisecond. As you can see, it is much more faster than the hard disk, so the external memory. And when we access a byte from a hard disk, an entire block of disk is read. These are called blocks with size 4096 bytes. So if we want to read, for example, an integer with 4 bytes from the random access memory, so from the main memory, then we are going to read that 4 bytes. Here, this is not the case for external memory. If we want to get an integer with the size 4 bytes, then the external memory is going to return approximately 4000 bytes, because it is able to return a single block or 2 blocks or 3 blocks and so on. It's not able to return just a few bytes, for example, because this is how external memory works. And basically that's why a node should have a size of approximately 4000, so 4096 to be precise, for external memories. So this is why basically binary search trees are not good for this kind of architecture, and that's why B-trees are needed. So far we had the data in the main memory, in the RAM. Now we have to fetch the data from the external memory to the main memory first, and that's why a different approach is needed. And okay, you may have the intuition that we just have to fetch the data, but this is exactly what I have been talking about, that accessing time for the hard disk is very, very slow, 19 milliseconds on average. So fetching the data is very, very slow from external memory to main memory. So okay, what could be the solution? So we should keep accessing data on the hard disk as minimum as possible, because this is the bottleneck basically. That's the slowest operation possible, 19 milliseconds. Okay. So for example, we have a binary search tree. We have a single key in a single node. In this situation, the keys are integers. And for example, we would like to search for the 5. We start at the root node. We come to the conclusion that we have to take the left child. We visit the 2, we come to the conclusion that 5 is greater than 2, and basically this is the item we are looking for. Okay, it is working absolutely fine for main memory, but for external memory it's not that good, because in every recursive method calls, so hopping to the next node in the binary search tree, takes a lot of time, because we have to search for the data on the disk, which is very slow. Basically, on every time we, for example, take the left child or the right child, we have to access the hard disk. And that's what's very slow. We have been discussing that it takes 90 milliseconds. So we take the root node. Okay, it's going to take 90 milliseconds to find the root node. Then we come to the conclusion that we have to go to the left. We have to search for the left child. It's going to take another 19 milliseconds. Then we come to the conclusion that we have to take the right child of the 2. Okay, we have to search for this item on the hard disk, so on the external memory. It's going to take another 19 milliseconds on average. So basically, the conclusion is that we should minimize the head reads. Basically, the head reads is finding the nodes in the binary search tree, and B-trees are much more compact, so fewer head reads are needed. So let's suppose the fact that we have a B-tree like this, and we are looking for 34. We just have to read the data this time, so we have to search for the 17, but it's not going to take any longer to find the neighbors, because it's going to belong to the same node. We come to the conclusion that we have to take this branch, and this is the 34 we are looking for. So basically in this situation, we had only 2 head reads. In the previous situation for binary search trees, we had 3 head reads. So the height of the B-tree is smaller, so fewer head reads are needed. And that's why in the external memory, it outperforms binary search trees, because these head reads are the operations that are going to cost a lot. And if we could minimize the head reads, then the algorithm is going to be faster and the data structure is going to be optimal. And basically, we are able to solve it with the help of B-trees. We can store more keys in a single node, and basically every node can have several children, and that's why the height of the tree is going to be smaller. So we have to use head reads fewer times, and that's why our algorithm is going to be faster. Thanks for watching.